You are a loud crowd.
Say one thing bad about Bernie Sanders online anywhere, and strident Sanders supporters may attack you personally. Multiple targets described to CNN what they call a Sanders swarm, an online army of supporters on Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, some even digging into their personal lives, trying to out their identity, bully, and frighten them into silence. MIT lecturer Michael Trice says over and over again, the bullying works.
The type of harassment that occurs, it is deeply hurtful, it's scary, it's frightening. Personally, I've had my job threatened online. Many people have experienced far, far worse. And unless someone is willing to do more, then yes, it can only escalate because it's effective.
An outspoken Elizabeth Warren supporter whose daughter with Down syndrome is just recovering from cancer was told, "You're stupid like your retard kid. Too bad the cancer didn't kill her." Sanders opponents are told to eat this poop and shut the F up. An activist dying of ALS tweeted support for Elizabeth Warren and was told, "Go F yourself." When the Working Families Party also endorsed Warren, it was swarmed. Bloodless scumbag hacks, corrupt, shameless. One user told the group's leader, who is black, slave masters had coerced his endorsement. The abuse so bad, Sanders had to respond, tweeting that ALS activist was actually a friend. And in another tweet, the candidate signaled to his followers that this campaign condemns racist bullying and harassment of any kind. It's not clear if the Sanders followers responsible are listening. In recent weeks, trolling Senator Elizabeth Warren as a snake, and in post after post, labeling Mayor Pete Buttigieg a rat.
Two victims of this tell CNN they were so afraid of the online attacks they faced, they don't even want us to describe the circumstances for fear it would start up again. They both just questioned the politics of Bernie Sanders in a public setting, and their personal lives were exposed and attacked.
Ben Decker, who studies online harassment and threats, says it's unclear how the swarms start. But Sanders supporters have been organizing in Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit communities since 2016 and have only grown stronger. And while social media harassment happens across the political spectrum, Decker says the sheer number of Sanders online supporters sets them apart from other followers.
I think any time where you have far greater numbers, you have far greater potential for harm. And in the online community, there are far greater Sanders supporters.
Decker used Facebook's data to analyze all the pages created by the supporters of Democratic presidential candidates and found the pro-Sanders pages have 2.5 million followers with nearly 58,000 posts in a three-month period, far more than all the other Democratic candidates combined. If only a fraction of those engage in nasty comments, they're still capable of bullying critics off social media.
And that kind of bullying that happens at scale is, it's crazy.
Sanders has insisted in several interviews those who hate online are not welcome in his campaign, and in a statement to CNN, his deputy communications director says the senator has said loudly and clearly there is no room in the political revolution for abuse and harassment online. Not enough, say those who study online abuse.
If you're not condemning it consistently, if your proxies within your campaign are not working against it and trying to do something different, then that's a real issue.
An issue of abuse, online bullying, and even threats that experts say is only growing. Drew Griffin, CNN, Boston.